Pesach is over, and the house is trashed. And I am looking around the room saying, what can I do to make this room look 50% better? And I thought I would do just a cleaning video while I'm cleaning. I didn't stick with my diet, obviously, based on the meat, but I still tried to be careful not to overdo the eating and not to combine things too badly. I discovered something with versus starches thing. That was interesting. Discovered that if I ate a meal that had no carbohydrate and I waited at least 3 hours, I could eat a completely carbohydrate meal and my blood sugars would stay good. The problem with blood sugars came from meals of combined fat and carb, like pancakes with butter. Yes, I did have that. Not
tiny.
Not a good idea for me. But I was kind of in a, flavor thing, and I thought, oh my gosh, I'm having this baby. I need to eat something, and I want to eat this, so I did. Excuses. Yes, I did have one case of false labor. The day after the first labor. So then that basically after what was it? First days there. And girl, what are you doing with that? Don't touch it, it'll fall. Ruby, Raffle, come here. Come help me. So, yeah, my sugar responses was surprised me. I've been so good on the no fat thing for weeks, thinking I was making my insulin receptors more sensitive by not having any fat. But I discovered that eating a high fat meal, as long as there was no carbohydrate mixed in, did not impair my insulin for the next meal of carbohydrate, which was really not what I expected. So I'm kind of on a new track. I'm not sure if I'm going to do this after the baby comes or what, probably. But I'm going to try a little bit of like Dr. Mark Hyman style eating sandwiched between mostly documents that we eating. Like, help here. McDougal style eating is like carbohydrate based, no additional protein necessary, no added fats on purpose, and you should eat vegetables to make your plate interesting. This super fat reducing one. What is it called? Anyway, he says you could eat half a plate of vegetables, half a plate of starch. But Dr. Mark Hyman's thing is to eat your plate 70% vegetables, and that other 30% should be fat and protein. Your protein isn't big of a deal. Other than if you're going to eat meat, it should be grass-fed, sustainable, etc., healthy, no antibiotics, and you're same with eggs. He recommends against dairy, so he calls it a pig or paleo-vegan style. Anyway, but his whole thing is definitely not majoring on the protein, which is typical with paleo, I think. So, yeah, I guess I don't have enough experience with paleo to know. I don't even know if you can see me in the camera, but I'm just over here cleaning on the floor. So... paleo vegan. Anyway, it's got my interest, and I'd like to try it as a solution for Shabbos meals, because Rocco, come out from under there. That's not good. No, you're gonna make it fall. Come. Don't let it fall. No. Come on. Brandy, need to come get you. Come get your phone. Come get your hairbrush. Come get your water. Anyway, I'm not gonna. She's gonna make that fall. Okay. Well, here she comes. Don't let it fall, honey. I need a bag for garbage. It's clear that he's had success with this high-fat diet, too. I'm starting to wonder if the real strong correlation with the good health is actually in the vegetables, and the fiber from the plant source, and that the meat is much less significant. Like, I already know that protein is not as big of a deal. Like, you don't need it. But it makes sense to me when most of the world doesn't avoid meat based on ideology. They actually get it. Eat it as often as they can, and they just don't get a lot of it. We're just missing some information. Missing something about vital health that is, I mean, obviously there's cliches like eat real food and if it came from a plant, or don't eat it, and if it is a plant, eat it. I don't know. There's stuff like that, but it doesn't really help you in the real world if you can't quantify what about it is working or not. Like, I guess some people can just get a plan and stick with it, but I'm not that kind of person. I know a lot of intellectual people who can buy into something for a time, but it's like, eventually you start wondering, well, why are these people healthy when they're not eating like that? Or anyway, kind of rambling, but my thought is that how the whole vitality and health challenge is, it's more complex and more, it comes down to something simple. And it could be, I could be wrong, as simple as managing your blood sugars, which can be done in a variety of ways. But blood sugar could be just a symptom of like weight gain versus loss. Like insulin, we know insulin is like the hormone responsible for weight gain. So if we can find a way to make our bodies, if we can find any manageable method of feeding ourselves that does not spike our insulin, we shouldn't gain any weight. And because most of us have just been eating, we're random eaters, we're not like purposely eating to gain weight or not to gain weight, we don't really know what combinations are making us gain weight, but it seems it's not as simple as calories in, calories out. It's not as simple as the fat you eat is the fat you wear, because you can live on fat and not get fat. Did you get wet? Did somebody spray you? Oh, you're still, you're so wet. Okay, well, it's not jammy time anyway. Anyway, what I'd like to try is to be more careful not to spike a blood sugar rise, which I think at this point comes down to don't overeat, because overeating can cause a spike, or at the very least do not overeat sugars. And if you're going to eat sugars like fruit, you should be active. Activity will prevent blood sugars from rising. Anyway, just some ramblings. I'm gonna go. I gotta take care of some kids. My room looks better. Hey. Just a minute, honey.